Welcome. It's nice to be with you all this great afternoon, this wonderful day of the Lord, the 12th day of the 12th month in 2017. What an awesome day to be in the presence. What an awesome day to be in the presence of the Lord. For this is the day the Lord has made. You will rejoice. I will rejoice. The world will rejoice. Because today is a great day. Today is a day of power. It's a day of authority where Satan has to bow. Satan, powers of darkness, has to bow because somebody's been lifted today. Somebody's elevated. Somebody's announced today. Somebody, your position, oh yes, have been retained. God has given you a position. There's a shift in the atmosphere that the enemy cannot stop what the Lord has placed for you all today. Get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready. I am so excited because God's word will tear down the kingdom of darkness. It is done in Jesus' name. Whoa. Congratulations. Congratulations for being in this place. So right now, I want to bring my word to you. And we are going to the book of Malachi. Malachi chapter 2, verse 2 to 3. Malachi chapter 2, 2 to 3. It says, if you will not hear, and if you will not lay it in heart to give glory unto my name, said the Lord of hosts, I will even send a curse upon you, and I will cause blessings, and I will cause your blessings to pass over, and I will have cursed them already, because ye do not lay it in heart. Verse 3 says, behold, I will corrupt your seed and spread dung upon your faces, even the dung of your solemn feast, and one shall take you away from it. Sons of God, my message today is, I refuse to labor under a curse. I want you to say it. I refuse to labor under a curse. Repeat it 3 times. Come on. Say it with your mouth, because you shall decree a thing and the Lord will bring it to pass. I want everybody, I refuse to labor under a curse. I refuse to labor under a curse. I refuse to labor under a curse. So many people all over the world today, they are laboring under curses. Knowingly, some unknowingly. Even the ones that know, how do I come out of this curse? How do I live a better life? So some people live like this till they die. Some people live like this bound and are just under somewhere, rejected, dejected, and they think the world is just against them. But there was something they were supposed to do. But I thank God today that you have known the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Somebody shout and say, I have known the truth, and the truth shall set me free. Say, I am getting some truth today that will set me free. The word of the Lord said, listen, because of disobedience of my people, because of their wickedness, because of their lying, because of they are unfaithful, they are not faithful to me. Now I will curse their seed, that their seed will not produce anything. Saints of God, if you want to live right, you want God to bless and bless, let us follow his instruction. Follow the word of God and you shall be set free. As I say today, so many people have been cursed. So many people have gone in the water to curse people. They do sacrifice, they place a curse. They go to the grave, they curse people. They take grave sand and they curse people. They go on a three-way junction, they curse. They go to your father's house, they go to the family house, they go to your in-law's house, they go to your outlaw's house. They begin to curse you. But there are some people that believe that these things are not existing. That knows those people, their life, look at it, something is wrong with them. If they think that the word of God is not true, it is already in the word. How can I say the word of God is not true? There are things we need to do. We must possess our possession. There's a divine inheritance for you. There's a divine position for you. There's a place of joy for you. There's a place of increase and harvest for you. But if you don't fight to break out of limitation, of stagnancy, of curses, you remain there all over your life. Somebody say it again. I refuse to labor under a curse. Say it. In the name of Jesus, I want you to say, you cross over. Say, I will cross over with blessings. Somebody tell it. I will cross over with blessings in the name of Jesus. Satan has release all kinds of agents, all kinds of satanic postmasters, demonic custom officers that have laid some checkpoints, demonic checkpoints against the children of God, that have come to tell you that there's deliverance in the house. The God of Esther, the God of Solomon, Mama, the God of Daniel is here to deliver somebody. The God of Joseph, the God of Joseph is here today. I want you all to know that in the name of Jesus, the God that took Joseph out of the pit, the God that took Esther out of slavery, my God, the God that took Daniel out of the lion's den, that God that delivered David out of the hand of Saul is in this place today. Get ready for a new move in the name of Jesus. Somebody say, I exchange my curses for blessings. Open your mouth and say, today I exchange every curse in me to blessings in the name of Jesus. There are so many curses, saints of God, going around people. People have been delayed. You want to get married, you are delayed. You want to get your job, you are delayed. Children that are smart cannot go to school. They go to school, they come back being redundant at home. They just leave them. Nothing can be done because all we think is just bookworm. How to take Tylenol, how to take antibiotics, how to take chemotherapy. But there's something that is greater than that. Oh my God, there's a divine all-round medication that is greater than that, that if you stand in him, his name is Jesus. When you take Jesus in you, there is nothing that the blood cannot do. Is somebody hearing me? So today, you are advancing. Somebody say, I'm moving from hindrance. Come on. Say, I'm moving from hindrance to acceptance. Come on. I move from hindrance to acceptance. Say, I move from lack to plenty. Come on. Move. Move, move. Yes, that is it. Congratulations. I move from lack to plenty. I move from backward journey to forward journey in the name of Jesus. Say, I must succeed. Shout it. Whether they like it or not, I must advance. Good. Whether they like it or not, I must progress into my place of abundance. I must progress into my place of abundance. Congratulations. Now we talk about, I refuse to labor under a curse. What is a curse? What is a curse? A curse is an invocation of harm, injury, or punishment. An invocation of harm, injury, or punishment upon someone, upon a thing, upon a land, upon a person, upon a nation, upon a thing, upon a land, upon a name, or many. Curse can be on anything. It's not only human being that can carry a curse. A land can carry a curse. A city can carry a curse. A nation can carry a curse. A marriage can be under a curse. A single can be under a marital curse. A single can be under wicked spell. Listen, we can all kinds of curses. There are different kinds. So don't think that it's only a man that can carry a curse. Curse can be anywhere. Your curse, your car that you even buy can be cursed. Your car that you pay money for can be cursed. So that is why, as children of God, when the Bible says pray without ceasing, it's because God already knows that Satan will fight your progress. That your progress, because Satan has come to steal, to kill, and to destroy. So all he's about to do is to make sure they hinder you. But I've come in the name of Jesus. I've come today that any curse placed on your head from your father's house, your mother's house, your in-law's house, even your outlaws, today I break. Somebody shall break. Somebody shall break. Break, break, say break their curses. Say it again. I refuse to labor under a curse. What is a curse? A curse is a kind of word. It's a word. It's a statement calling for some form of evil. They want you to die prematurely. They want you to struggle. Calling for a form of evil, misfortune, to fall on people, to fall upon a team. They can curse your car, have accident within 24 hours. If you don't pray on that car and you drive that car, you have accident. We as children of God, we are covered. And his presence covers us. But when something is cursed and you don't deal with the curse, no matter how far, the enemy will get you. Number three, what is a curse? It's an unrighteous word or a phrase. An unrighteous word or a phrase or a statement, oh my God, that empowers devil, empowers Satan to successfully destroy, to successfully walk against a victim. If you cannot come out of curse, you become a victim. If you allow the enemy to direct your life, you are in the mercy of that enemy to destroy you. You begin to suffer. So death, they begin to place their curse. A curse, I want to let you know, a curse flies faster than an aircraft. A curse is like the word that has two-edged sword. They can be anywhere and release the curse. They can be anywhere and release the curse, and it goes fast. So we should not play with these things called curses. That's why the Lord said, give them this so that this year, they end this year free and enter their success. Somebody say, freedom. Say, freedom. Say, I break every curse and I step into my freedom to get into my 2018. Come on, come on, come on. I see you, daughter. You are doing it. That curse that they place on you right now, it is broken. You have struggled in America, struggled to do all kinds of things to prosper. The more you struggle, the more backward you go. When doors are open, the enemy comes to strike. That is a curse. But I want to tell you that God is here today to break every level of curses. Not one level, all the levels. Curses have levels, all the levels of curses. So what is a curse? A curse is an evil utterance directed at someone. If they hate you with their wicked power, they place a curse directed at someone. Like Elisha caused those children that was telling him, bad head. He said, listen, now take it. And a bear came and swallowed those children. You see, curses, if we don't act right, it works. Because it's like a covenant. Curses, that's why the Bible says, the Lord said, my covenant will I not break, neither alter the words that have come out of my mouth. Listen, if you obey a covenant, everything goes well. But if you go against it, there's a curse. Let me say, you used to go to witch doctors. You used to serve other gods. And all of a sudden, you want to stop not serving. There's a curse if you don't use the blood of Jesus. If you don't engage the blood of Jesus to deliver yourself, you are under a curse, which means you were in a covenant and you did not remember to break it like our parents. That's why we are under curses today, because the person that did it did not remember to break it. Now we are covered with all this type of limitation, stagnancy, because the curse, there's a covenant. There was a covenant that was broken. But today, any evil covenant that was broken and the devil is pursuing you to bring you back, I clear you with the blood of Jesus. I wash you today that the effect of that covenant will not spoil your marriage. Look at you, young girl. You just got married and your people are fighting your marriage tooth and nail, tormenting you in marriage. And if you don't hold on, please hold on. You need deliverance. You need to go meet somebody. Let them lay hand and baptize you with Holy Ghost fire, because the enemy wants to break your marriage. There's a curse that nobody stays in marriage peacefully in your family. The ones that are there, they are struggling. So now you step in and you are playing with your marital life. It is time to rise up and break that curse. So today I break it. I pray that the God of wonders will visit you. So what is a curse? A curse is anything that is anti-blessing. If you are not, everything you do, rejection, bad luck, you are under a curse. Anything that works against blessing, work against progress, is a curse. There's a force behind it. A curse is an authoritative pronouncement that seeks to alter or to stop progresses, to stop your progress, to stop your advancement. It is type of an utterance. They alter it. They go to places to stop you. But a curse is intended to keep you bound. Do you hear me? A curse is not a blessing. A blessing makes you go forward. A blessing is open door. The Bible says the blessings of the Lord make it rich and adds no sorrow. But a curse is opposite to a blessing. A curse, what does curse? Curse limits you. He afflicts you. The curse opened door for attack. The curse opened door for attacks. Hardship, frustration, living from paycheck to paycheck. Disfavor, failure. You have been failing. Until your name, your mid-name is now failure. And people look at you and say, you know that boy that is always failing in college? That boy. So now you have been given a name that you don't know where it came from. It's because of a curse. I break that curse in the name of Jesus. I break it from today in the name of Jesus. There are curses that follow people all their life. As I told you, there are people that are dead today because of curses. But they didn't know how to break it. They died the curse. They were cursed with death. And because they did not rise up in the name of Jesus to break it, they died. But today, any curse, come on, speak in your name. Say, any curse in the name of Jesus that is afflicting my personal life, pray it. That is afflicting my personal life, that is afflicting my business, my job, my career, I break it. Say it again, say, I break it. One more time, I break it. Oh my God. If there's a curse in your life, you don't take care of it, it grows deeper. It increases daily. It expands. You know the way that faith grows, that's how curses grow. If you don't deal with it, you see that you go deeper in that curse and things become worse for you. Look at, let us go to the book of 1 Chronicles. 1 Chronicles chapter 4 verse 27. 1 Chronicles chapter 4 verse 27 says, Shimei had 16 sons and 6 daughters. Can you imagine? But none of his brothers had large family. None of his brothers had large family. They had small. The one that had one child, the one that had two, no one extended like from Abraham to Isaac. Look at that. Abraham had Isaac. Isaac had only who? You see what we are talking about? Isaac had two, Jacob and Esau. Then look at Joseph. Look at Esau. So thank God somebody was able to break out, to prosper. Today you will be that Joseph that will break out. Today you will break out from that curse in your life. I say today, somebody is breaking out that curse will not complete, not focus, will not succeed in your life in the name of Jesus. Look at Shimei. He had children. He had 16. He has daughters. But his brothers, everyone were limited. They didn't have why? Because there was a force. There was an attack. There was a curse. But nobody was able to break it. Nobody. A lot of times, when we go through some situation, we are focused on what the book says. Listen, this is the time that word said, lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him, for he shall direct your path. Though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. For the weapon of our warfare is not carnal. Listen, when you are under a curse, until you deal with it, you will struggle. That is where you have going around. Go around circle. You begin to go around. Because why? You have not dealt with it. You can get the book. You can do all you want to do. But unless you deal with that situation, you are still the same. So look at this. The brothers, none of them prospered. None of them had. But one of them was able to have. Like Jabez. Jabez, the Bible says, Jabez, the mother bore her in pain, in sorrow. But Jabez, when Jabez got up, Jabez prayed, oh God, that you may enlarge my cause. Oh, that you may bless me indeed. Jabez knew that he was under a curse. He said, oh, that Lord, you may bless me indeed and enlarge my territory. He knows that his territory was under attack. He knew that his foundation was under attack. Look at all his brothers and cousins and nephews. He knew that all of them were working in some tough demonic foundation. There are some of you today, your foundation are very tough. The devil has tied. The devil has bound. But I've come in the name of he that died and rose, that I break that curse out of your life today. Break in the name of Jesus. Somebody shall break. Say, leave me alone. Curses from my foundation. Break. Somebody break it. Say, break in the name of Jesus. Shout it again. Break. Listen, if there's a curse in your life, you are going to face all kinds of negative forces, all kinds of enchantment, all kinds of divination, like Nebuchadnezzar. They said King Nebuchadnezzar he always arrived at three-way junction. Look at Ezekiel chapter 21. Ezekiel 21:21. For the king of Babylon, this is what the enemy does. And children of God are in their house sleeping. Sleeping at midnight when they should be praying. But at midnight, the enemies are three-way junction. At midnight, the enemies are three-way junction, cursing you. Trying to make sure your business don't prosper. Trying to make sure you struggle on earth. Trying to make sure they take away your progress, your vision, your star. Listen, today I have come in the name of Jesus. Affliction cannot arise a second time. Affliction cannot arise a second time. So what did he say? For the king of Babylon stood at the parting of the way, at the head of the two-way. He stood there, took time, took pain, because he wanted to accomplish something, and yet it is vanity. But we children of God, we don't look at what God has said. We don't look at our heavenly benefits. We don't look at where we are going. We are so distracted, and as distracted as we are, the devil continues to destroy. Jesus have mercy. Somebody say, I come out of curses. Come on, shake your body, shake your head. I see a woman, there's a mark in your middle of your head. When you were small, your mother took you to all these voodoo priests, all these satanic priests. And because you were sick, they caught you. And they thought the maid, somebody would kill you. So they put a mark. That mark is the reason why you are struggling today. Please call my secretary right now. As I'm talking to you, when I'm finished, call my secretary, give your name, and I'll get back to you. Call my secretary, say you are the one that carried that evil mark. Your mother took you to that voodoo place. They put some blood, something on you. That is why nothing is working for you. So you get your anointing or get your covenant on, and I'm, by the grace of God, I'm going to connect you to. You call the prayer line right now. So what did this king of Babylon go to do at three-way Joshua? To curse, to release divination, to release witchcraft, enchantment, enchant. Let them not have children. You just got married. You are even still at the hall doing your reception. Somebody is at three-way Joshua cursing you. Oh, come on. Huh? You are doing your engagement. Huh? That is why I tell people, whenever you are celebrating, remember Satan is there. He will want to go right in the middle of your celebration. You may not see then, but after a while it will come. So people don't know this, that your time of celebration is the highest time of praying. That is the time you give your life to God more than you have ever. Because Satan does not want anything good. Don't think when things are good, it's good in the kingdom of God, in the kingdom of darkness. No, they want to strike you. They want to make sure that because that time you are not praying, you are distracted. So that is when they sow the seed. The Bible says, while men slept, an enemy came and sowed evil seed. So whenever you are celebrating, wherever there's joy, know that there's sadness somewhere. Weeping may tarry through the night, but joy comes in the morning. So keep your eyes watchful, be prayerful, because Satan is not sleeping. He went to three-way junction, consulting his images, consulting his evil mirrors, attacking people, attacking the progress of others. Today, any king of Babylon that has taken your name to the water, I arrest them by fire. Any king of Babylon that have taken your children, that have taken your ministry, look at you, a minister. That is why you are misbehaving. Minister, you better stop because you will die in the altar. You are in the altar destroying the children of God. You are in the altar having fornication with people in your church. You better stop it, please, because you are bringing a curse. It's in your foundation anyway. You should break it immediately because a woman wants to destroy you. He wants to destroy. It's time for pastors to be real. If we say we are pastors, if we say we are children of God that lead others, let us lead by example. I see you, and God said, let me tell you that word. You better serve God in spirit and in truth and purge yourself. Don't go back again to that in Jesus' name. So what are we saying? The king of Babylon come to destroy. He releases evil word to curse. But thank God in verse 21. That is Ezekiel 22, verse 27. Ezekiel 21, verse 27. Ezekiel 21, verse 27 says, I will overturn. Who said God? I will overturn. He said it three times. I will overturn. I will overturn. I will overturn. And it will be no more. That is your God. I will overturn their wickedness against them until I don't see them anymore. I will overturn their witchcraft. Let it backfire. I will overturn their wickedness. And I will give you freedom. Yes, sir. Until I give you what I want to give you. Saints of God, our God does not sleep nor slumber. This is a month of celebration and good news. Say, this is my month of celebration and good news. Somebody say it. It is my month of celebration and good news, and I must receive my good news in the name of Jesus. Now, many kinds of, there are other kinds of curses, personal curses, marital curses, poverty curses. There are different kinds. But there are two that I want to tell you right now that is really, really, really increasing and attacking the whole world, which is generational curses and ancestral curses. It's so rampant everywhere. What is a generational curse? These are curses that pass on from one person. It pass on from one person to another person, from one predecessor to one successor. So somebody takes it. Somebody hands it over. Somebody indirectly, we are under that curse. It just come. You don't need to activate it. It's already in the foundation because it was not broken. So right now, that curse, generational, you have your child right now. It falls into that curse. You had your child yesterday. It falls till you stand up and break it. The generational curse continues from one person to the other. What is generational curse? It is inherited curses that last up to the third. It lasts up to the third and the fourth generation. Oh, yes, sir. It continues from one generation to the other. If you read Exodus 20, verse 5, it's going to tell you. What is generational curse? It is that unpleasant event in the family. Generational curse. Everybody's poor in the family. Oh, some people are barren. Nobody gets married in this family. You marry, you come back home. You marry, you end up single. Yes, it's good to celebrate the marriage. But after the marriage, 1, 2, 3 years, they don't cross 3, they don't cross 4, they don't cross 5 years. Even If the one that crosses, they bear it. They were saying, no, I don't want this shame in my family. I don't want this shame. I want to keep it. Because why? They are trying to bear to stop the shame. But nobody is dealing with the curse. Generational curse is that unpleasant event in the family, in your business. Continuous customers and others. You have this business today. People are prospering in that business. You are failing in the business. To you, the business is not working, but to somebody, it's a joy. To somebody, it is a joy. It's an opportunity to have such a business because they see the glory of God in it. But to you, it is like it's not working because there's a curse. It happens in your business, in establishment. A curse can continue. Community, there's community curse, generational, even in the church. Some people start church today, they cannot continue because there's a curse in it, and the curse stops the church. You can start it today. 3 years you start, it breaks because there is a curse. It can be in the church, it can be in a nation. So you see that pattern. It's like a pattern. The same thing that happened 4 years, it happens now. The same thing that happened to your mother, the same thing that happened to your father, you see it begin to happen in your life and in the life of your children. That is a generational curse. Generational curse are those curses as a result of sin. The Bible says our parents have sinned. Lamentation chapter 5. They have sinned and are not, and we bond their iniquity. Lamentation chapter 5 verse 7. Sin, disobedience, they are supposed to serve God, they were serving idols. They're supposed to raise altar for God, they were raising altar for Satan. They were raising images like Nebuchadnezzar. There are some of you that your fathers even left image. There are images that they worship. Some of them worship snakes. Some of them worship animals. If you don't break that curse, that is why you are sleeping, something is crawling in your body. Your children are sleeping, they say, Mommy, I saw a snake. You saw a snake every time in your dream because there's a connection. There's something that connects somebody with that snake that had not been broken. Today I come. Any serpent in your foundation, Chapukura, any serpent in your foundation that is tormenting your life, today that curse, the covenant between you and that serpent is broken. I say in the name of Jesus, the covenant between you, Mokorokoto, with that serpent is broken, or any satanic animal, I break it. Even the altar that you don't know about, that when you were born, they lay you in that altar. You were a child. You did not know. Now the word is spoken. That altar is fighting everything you want to do. You begin to see strange spirit, marine spirit, strange women coming to have sex with you. Today, I break that curse. I say, I break. Somebody shall break. Somebody jump up and shall break. Jesus, have mercy. Look at your mother. How many husbands did she marry? Look at the type of life she lived. Is your mother still married now? Sickness. So if you are in marriage right now, and you are struggling with marriage, look at your father's house. Look at your mother's house. If you see that it's not right there, you better break that curse. If not, it is generational. It is generational. This is what we didn't know. So I break it today in the name of Jesus. What about ancestral curse? Ancestral curse. Ancestral curses are those curses that manifest in lives of all offsprings. Every child that is there suffers what the ancestral, is almost the same, but there's a little difference. Yes, that ancestral curse, it works in the offsprings. It attacks every person that grows in that life. What the ancestors did, they ate blood. You begin to suffer blood problem. They ate blood. They kill innocent soul. They ate human being. You begin to see dead people coming to attack you in your dream. The ancestors, they stole so many things. You are sleeping in your dream. You see your purse missing. Your car missing. Things are not working. You gather, they scatter. Because your ancestors, they were scattering people. So that is the life they live. And now, you are now struggling with ancestral curse. Because it was not broken by your parents. They are genealogical. Ancestral curses are genealogical. Arabaka. Talking about all those type of blood problem. All those type of blood. And it's so severe because anything blood takes blood. How can you withdraw blood from somebody? So that ancestral curses that are genealogical curses, they come as a result of sin of your parents, sin of your ancestors. What they did, those polygamous life, they were polygamous, but now one wife is not enough for you. One husband, even as a wife, you go to work, you are looking at other men, and there's a husband in the house. So that type of thing, look at it in your foundation, is there. is there, and if you don't break it, he attack you. Somebody shout, I come out of ancestral curses. Shout and say, in the name of Jesus. Shout, in the name of Jesus, I come out of every ancestral curse. In the name of Jesus. My God, somebody is breaking right now. It's breaking from your life. You will live well. You're 2018. This is the curse. The curse that have been attacking you. But in Jesus' name, as you leave this month to January, you're living free. These are curses that travel through the bloodline. Ancestral curses travel through the bloodline. Anything in the blood moves from one level to the other. Sickle cell, it moves from one person to the other. That thing that troubled your mother, that thing that troubled her, you look at it, everybody suffers it. It moves from bloodline in the family, in tribe, in races, in whole community. Anything that affects the blood, it affects everybody in that community because they are all like linked together. In that village, you send your sickness. There's a village in Africa where nobody goes there to marry because they said the blood, there's a bad blood there. If you marry from those people, you'll be cursed all your life. They call them curses. So that is an ancestral curse in that village. And nobody, instead of them to rise up to break the curse, they are separating themselves, causing rejection. This is something we cannot ignore. It is time to rise up and break the curse. No, I refuse to labor under a curse. Somebody say, no, I refuse to labor under a curse. You don't know about the curse. Get up and break the curse in the name of Jesus. Jesus, thank you, Father. So we are going to pray. Everybody get ready. Say, I bind all curses pronounced upon my life. That happens from one generation to the other. I bind, I break all curses. That is pronounced. All curses working all over my life from one generation to the other. I break it, begin to break it. I break that curse. I bind it together, all curses. I bind together all curses, all evil pronouncement. I repeat it again. I bind it, it will not move. I bind together all curses. All evil pronouncement upon my life and upon my children, and I wipe it out with the blood of Jesus. Come on, I wipe out that curse with the blood of Jesus. You engage, these are things we need to engage, the blood of Jesus, because there's no other blood that can speak victory other than the blood of the Lamb, in the name of Jesus. We go to prayer point number two. Say, every generational and ancestral curse, shout it, every generational and ancestral curse operating in me, break, 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 break it three times. Every generational and ancestral curse working in my life, working against me, break, break, break in the name of Jesus. Congratulations. We pray prayer point number three. My Father, deliver me from ancestral and generational curses. My Father, deliver me from this ancestral and generational curses that is working against my life. My Father, deliver me. Pray that prayer. My Father, deliver me. Call on God. The Bible says, call upon Him. He will answer you. And in this prayer mountain, in this prayer we are right now, there's an altar. Come, somebody open your mouth. An altar of the King of Kings. So when you pray in an altar, He answers you. So lift up your voice. Say, I break every generational, every ancestral curse tormenting my life in the name of Jesus. Now you pray again. Everything I have lost, come on, everything I have lost as a result of curses. Some people could not continue in school. Some people went to school of nursing. The day they were taking exam, that was the day they were asked to leave. The day they were taking exam, somebody went to nursing school, the day when they were supposed to come for final exam, they slept. They slept, they couldn't wake up. They woke up after 2 hours when the exam is over. Tell me, is that normal? Oh, I refuse to labor under a curse. Somebody shout, shout. I refuse. When they say come to interview, you woke up early, but you get there late when interview is over. What is that? That is a curse. Where you are walking in the dream, all of a sudden everybody leaves you alone. It's a curse of rejection. You are cursed. You are under a curse. And with that type of life, you cannot succeed. You are just alone by yourself. You carry something right now, all of a sudden it disappears from your hand. You enter your house, there's a flood in your house. You just buy new furniture. In your dream, you are seeing that there's a flood. The curse is working. They want to empty you. But in Jesus' name, you shall not be emptied. In the name of Jesus. That is why Jabez cried. Jabez! Abel said, no, I cannot repeat the history of my father's house. Somebody jump up and say, I will not repeat the evil history of my father's house. Come on. I will not repeat the evil history of my father's house. Repeat it. My God, I feel the Holy Ghost. Somebody has been set free right now. There's deliverance going on now. Don't think that because I'm not laying hand on you. Just think that because you are not under that covering of Alpha. God is here right now. This is a national altar. And I want you to know you are getting your deliverance if only you believe. Yes, Jabez called on his God. Now, who cursed you? Who cursed you? Who is speaking against you? What is it that every time you dream, you see river in front of you? Every time you something good will happen, you see river. When you wake up in the morning, something happens. Because that is it. You are laboring under a curse. Why is it that you see yourself in the grave at times, dead people? You see yourself in a place nobody talks to you, but everybody's talking to one another. You are under a serious curse. I send that curse back. Somebody say, I send it back. Shout it again. Say, I return back any curse that I'm operating under. Come on, say break and go back to sender. Shout it, say break, 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 break. And look at you single. How many disappointments have you got? How many disappointments? They come so sweet, everything work at the last minute, they are gone. It's a curse. It's a bad curse. Promise and fail, it is a curse. Oh my God. Somebody say generational curse, break. Family curses, break. Come on, personal curses, break, break. Break! Thank you, Jesus. Look at Gehazi. Look at the mistake Gehazi did. Gehazi was under a double anointed prophet with Elisha. What did he do? You see, when there's a curse in your life, no matter how nice the place you are is, you live there like a pig. You live like a pig. You live disgrace. Look at Gehazi that would have been one of another leader. He was cursed at the end. While he was under a curse, he didn't take care of it. Now, deliverance was done to Naaman. Instead of him to say the truth, he went to take bribe. He went to do manipulate and got all the things when he was not supposed to. Okay, now he did it. Instead of you to say the truth, he told the lie. Then Elisha said, take it. Leprosy. The leprosy of Naaman will not depart from you. And what happened? He left his presence white. This is somebody that was on fire, because if you are under fire, you are fire. We are fire today because our God is a consuming fire. That is why we are like fire, because our God, look at what did he inherit? Leprosy. There are people here that the good you have done, you ended up wrong. Why? Because there's a curse. The curse says you cannot cross that level. So upon all the good things you do, people praise you, praise you, praise you. The end, they fire you. The end, nobody acknowledges what you do. So that is broken today. In the name of Jesus, it is broken. Gehazi left his presence with leprosy. So Naaman that was supposed to be leopard, now transferred his leprosy to Gehazi because of a curse. Every evil transfer of sickness, every evil transfer of affliction, I return back now, now, now. I break it, go to sender. Because you are here today, you don't know why you are here. You are not here by accident. God wants to deliver you so that you enter your 2018 with victory, success, abundance, overflow, prosperity. Somebody shout prosperity. Shout it again. Say prosperity. Our fathers have seen that are not, and we bond their iniquity. That is it. We carry their sin. We carry their sin. Some of us are still operating on the sin of our parents. The curse is still continuing. That is why God has sent his word today. His word is healing you. His word is restoring you. Let us dwell on that secret place in the name of Jesus. What about Joshua? The Bible says in Joshua chapter 6, verse 26. Joshua chapter 6, verse 26. Jericho was cursed. And was cursed on the head of the firstborn. I brought this one for you to know. At times we begin to blame our children. We blame our children. You don't know what you did. What you did or your ancestors did that brought the curse to that innocent child. But we begin to place curse on them. That's why I say pray for your children, because most 99% of what they are going through is not their fault. It's somebody somewhere did it. So let us pray for our children to bring them back. So he said the curse will be upon the firstborn of that person and the lastborn. Imagine. So there was a curse. But thank God for the double anointing on Elisha. The double anointing, Elisha said, give me cruse of salt. Yes, he took it to the stream of water. He said, there shall be no more curse. There shall be no more curses. There shall be no more premature death. There shall be no more bitterness. I'm declaring on somebody's life today. I break that curse under that double anointing. I stand under that double anointing of Elisha. I operate under that double anointing of Elisha. I tap under that double anointing of Elisha. And I break every curse that want to take your life, take your children's life, take your destiny, take your calling, take your purpose in life. I break in the name of Jesus. Yes, it is done. It is done. But look at it. That somebody that does not know how it happened, carry the curse. Put your hand on your head. Say, any curse from my foundation that is working against my destiny, I command you to break. Come on, somebody pray that prayer. Because I see so many of you being cursed. I see someone, you are carrying some inherited curses. You are carrying some inherited load on you that is not helping you. Place your hand on that head. Say, in the name of Jesus, every inherited curse, every generational curse, every generational curse, every ancestral curse that is upon my head to make me limited all my life, to make me stagnant all my life, I break you. I break you. I break you in Jesus' name, my God. So what does it mean to labor under a curse? What does it mean to labor under a curse? To labor under a curse is to be under a shell. Is to be under a shell, under a mask. You are under a shell. What can you do under a shell? Like a tortoise. Nobody knows the tortoise skin until tortoise skin is brought out. When you labor under a shell, you labor under a covering, you labor under satanic umbrella or demonic blanket, you are dead. Nobody sees you like a beautiful single under that situation. Nobody knows how beautiful you can be. All educated, you can be the best behaved, you can be so much, you know God, but because you are under a covering, until you come out of that covering, there's a curse. Until you break that covering to come out. So when we say labor under a curse, we are saying that you are laboring without being noticed. You are working so hard. It's like you working in your job, being the best worker, always on time. Nobody see you. But the ones that they are seeing, the ones that even came late are the ones they are promoting. The ones that don't know what they are doing. So you are laboring under a curse. They pronounce curse on you. So no matter what you do, they don't see. They don't appreciate you. Nobody appreciates you. Nobody congratulates you. Yes, sir. You labor without being recognized. Nobody recognizes what you do. Nobody appreciates what you do. They don't celebrate you. But look at the ones that just came. They begin to celebrate them and they are not half as good as you. So you are laboring under a curse. You operate below expected capacity. You labor below it. But you did well. You studied. You went to school, studied. The day of exam, they say you failed. But you knew it. You were under a curse. You were under a spell. To press down with generational liability. When you carry generational liability, your father cannot take care of the children. Your parents know you are the one they are calling every day. Bring this. The money you want to use to buy a car. The one you want to use to even pay. There are people that cannot even afford to pay apartment. But yet they are helping people out there. But the people don't even know how they are struggling. You understand? So you are laboring under that curse. Under that curse pressure. They put so much pressure in you. You look at you, laughter, laughing is like a big load. You don't even want to smile. When you smile, you look like fake. Yes, sir. So you are pressed down with all kinds of generational liability, all kinds of unprofitable liability, unprofitable labor. You walk, nothing is happening. So you are working under a curse that will be broken today. You walk under a curse when you stumble and experience perpetual loss. Perpetual loss in business, perpetual loss in your job, perpetual loss you gather, you lose, even in marriage, even in your personal life. Nothing is blessed. When people are being blessed, you go where they are blessed, your own end up with curse. You go where everybody is happy and live, where you go there, somebody slaps you, it causes commotion. That there are people that when they step in a place, it's commotion. When they step in a place, the atmosphere change. They carry curse. There are people that can be in a team. The team was fine. That team has been operating for 5 years, no problem. The day they step on that team, trouble. Everybody's fighting one another. Everybody. Somebody with a curse is there, like Jonah. Like Jonah, until Jonah repented in the belly of the fish. And somebody hearing me, today, that fish that is looking for you will bust it. You will repent today so that your life will turn around in Jesus' name. You eat, you had labor. You eat like ants. You eat like ants, but you walk like elephants. You walk, people that are eating honey, they enjoy it. Your own honey is bitter. Who put bitter leaf in your honey? Because there's a curse. Curse is not sweet. Curse is bitter. So you labor under that hardship. Hardship. Nothing is working for you. You gather, you ask, you are gathering, you are losing. You keep here, by the time you come back, it is gone. There's a curse. You suffer disappointment. Your miracle becomes trouble. People are receiving miracle, they are testifying, they are happy. Your own, when you want to testify, trouble come again. So your testimony begins to lack. I mean, your testimony is there, but it's not shown. You saw it right now, you want to testify, trouble come. That means you carry a curse. You suffer perpetual rejection, shame, poverty, like a church rat. A church rat, in a church, there's no food. So a church rat is very poor, it's lean, because it doesn't see food, it doesn't see fish to eat, it doesn't see bread to eat. Any power that has converted your life to a church rat, I curse that power. I cut off their head. I say today, you must arise and shine. You must fulfill your purpose in the name of Jesus. So what are we saying? How, look at all this is business suffer, business struggle. You got business today, tomorrow is gone. Marital failure. You get married like other people. You struggle in marriage. You struggle, you try. Disappointment, you are rejected. You that was so loved before, you that were like honey, you were like sweet. All of a sudden you become bitter. What do you think is happening? This is not time to quarrel. It is time to fix it. It is time to go to God and repent. Father, whatever part I played in this, forgive me. And my father, I pray whatever thing my parents did, I want to be used to break this curse. Some of us need to stand on that gap. We need to stand on that gap to break the curse from our family so that we will reap every child, everybody will move forward. If Elisha had not broken the curse, look at so many people that would have suffered. So today, God, you are in this prayer line right now, or you are in this prayer mountain, let me call it that way, because God wants to use you to break the curse and make sure what you are learning today, put it in practice in the name of Jesus. You have all kinds of attack. All kinds of raging. Nothing is working. Delay. Difficulties. Yes, diversion of blessing. You get blessing today, tomorrow is gone. Oh, yes, sir. Come and see what God is doing. While you are trying to tell somebody, another problem comes. So what am I saying? We need to break that yoke. Somebody say, I break it. Somebody shout, say, I break it. Shout, I break it. In the name of Jesus. Aborted blessings. Aborted marriages. Aborted jobs, aborted education, aborted businesses. You suffer that because there's a curse. There's a force that is stopping it. Inability to persist. Inability to stand firm. At times, they even attack your prayer life. Inability to pray. You used to be praying very well. Active, fire. Listen, it's not all prayer that are prayer. Some people just want to pray because they say pray. But if you see some people pray, where things move, mountain move, that's what I'm saying. It's not just follow the schedule of prayer, and yet you are not praying prayer as you are supposed to pray. Hot fire in the name of Jesus. So you suffer rejection, you suffer hatred, you suffer constant fear. That spirit of phobia. You are always afraid. Every little bit, somebody passes you, you think something is happening because you are under a spell. You are under a curse. Suicidal attempts. At times you just feel, what am I living for? There's nothing living for. Let me just give it. It is a curse. You see, demotion, they are always thinking of demoting you. You suffer demotion. You suffer suicidal attempt, sudden bankruptcy. Every time you just see that your hand is almost empty, you are under a spell. Strange voices attack you. Yes, marital problem, from one problem to the other. Iron-like problem is hard to solve. Sickness become chronic. Sickness that people get their healing. Your own, every day you have to go and see a doctor. Is that how you end it this year? I cut off that. Every month, every week, you go and see a doctor. How many times have you seen Dr. Jesus? How many times have you booked appointment with Dr. Jesus? But human being, you take that as something. You know you are under a curse. So that is the only way you can back up. That's the only way you can feel it. Mistreatment. You are being mistreated, being victimized. Oh, every time people talk about me, something is wrong with you. If every time you are the talk of the day, tell God, Father, I don't want this. I refuse to labor under a curse. Wherever this curse is coming from, I break. Somebody say, I refuse to labor under a curse. Say it. Say it again. I refuse to labor under a curse. You begin to see yourself on addiction. addicted to so many things, drugs, all substances, masturbation, things that you should keep your body as a temple of the Holy Ghost. But you find yourself in it. You don't want to do it. All of a sudden, you start doing it. That tells you there's a curse that wants to put you in trouble to make sure you don't move forward. Major setback. You see, major setback. Listen, today, that major setback, every curse, every affliction, I break it today. That whoever is activating, I want you to pray. Say, whosoever is activating curses, repeat it. Whosoever is activating curses over my life, your time is up. Your time is up. Break, I disconnect from you. Break, I disconnect from you in the name of Jesus. How do we break curses? How do we break curses? Number one, give your life to God completely. We need to learn to give. This is no time to give God half. The Bible tells me that a double standard man is unstable. You cannot give half. It's time for 100%. Give your heart to God 100%. Serve God 100%. I see Christians, they call themselves Christians, they keep malice. They don't want to serve God. Some Christians at this age are still visiting false prophets. Some Christians at this age are still going to do sacrifice by the waterside. Some Christians at this age are still, they call themselves Christians, but they are in satanic churches. That is a curse. Because if you are under a curse, they will make sure you don't go to the right place. If you are under a curse, they will make sure if you are a man, you will begin to marry only witches. You marry witches that will kill you. You marry witches that will destroy you. Because why? They want to waste your life. They want to use that witch to waste you. Because it is in their program. Any program curses against your life, I break it today by fire. I say I break it in the name of Jesus. You see, arm yourself with the word of God, number two. Number one, give your life to God completely. Number two, arm yourself. Study to show yourself approved. Use the word of God. Arm yourself. Let it be engrafted in you with the word of God. Because this word is sharper than two-edged sword. In his name, every knee shall bow. So arm yourself with the word of God. Identify the particular cause. What cause am I operating on? Is it financial? Is it family? Is it generational? Is it ancestral? What kind of cause? Is it the cause I place on myself? Is it marital when I married, after marriage this came? Identify the kind of cause and deal with it with the word of God. Restore back. Ask God to restore back what you have lost. Make sure you repent. Repent of all your sins. You also repent of your ancestral sin. You were not there, but like, Father, forgive me. The sin of my parents. The sin of my ancestors. Whatever they did that I don't know, I ask for forgiveness in the name of Jesus. Then you begin to renounce the curse. Begin to renounce it. Dissociate yourself from every curses. Dissociate. I dissociate myself. Somebody say, I separate myself. Begin to say it. Say, I separate myself from every curse. Every curse of the flesh. Every curse of the flesh, begin to dissociate yourself in the name of Jesus. There are some people, they can't stay without women. There are some girls, they can't stay without men. They are not their husband, but that is the life. So it's a curse. You better break it in the name of Jesus. So you reverse the curse back to where it went and bring in blessing. You begin to bring in blessing. Then you render your life too hot. Render your life too dry. Render your temple too dry for the enemy to operate on. Render it too dry for the enemy to operate on. You, before you go to bed, say, Father, this my body is Holy Ghost fire. Right now, I inject my body with Holy Ghost fire. When you inject yourself with Holy Ghost fire, what demon want to come inside Holy Ghost fire? Holy Ghost fire is the consuming fire of God. So when you begin to inject yourself with Holy Ghost fire, I break that foundation of curses today, and I command you not to come back. You do not. Every night do it, because it's stubborn. You keep on saying that in the name of Jesus. Yes, sir. Then you make sure you bring yourself to God every day before you sleep, in the morning, in the night, in the morning, in the night, in the name of Jesus. And begin to give all to God. If it is your job, say, Father, let the enemy not be able to touch your job. I'm tired of moving from one job to the other. This job, from one job to the other, I'm tired. It's a curse. I break it. So you render it to God and you say, Lord, I command the power fighting this to be powerless today. I command any power fighting my job, my business, making me to struggle to be powerless. Is somebody hearing me? Then you walk by faith. The Bible says without faith, it is impossible to please God. When you walk by faith, if there's a man of God, a woman of God that knows deliverance, like myself, you go there and say, Father, listen, I'm going through this. I need prayer. Let her continue to lay hand on him. Lay hand on you. Break it while you are walking on your own. You're walking on your own. She's walking on you. It will continue to break because it's stubborn. Curses are stubborn. So walk in faith. Invoke the blessings of God. Invoke it. Begin to call it. And begin to walk upon the blessings of God. Begin to anoint your head every day. If you are under a curse, anoint your head every day. Make sure the anointing oil is powerful, like the one we have in Alpha and Omega. Make sure you use it. Use your covenant oil. Begin to anoint your head every day with that oil and break that curse. Yes, give sacrificially. Give to God sacrificially. Everything. Say, Father, I give you. And again, after you've gone through this deliverance, it's good to sow a seed. You say, Father, I bring this seed to raise an altar. Against the altar, the ancestral altar, the witchcraft altar, the generational altar in my father's house, the generational altar in my village, I use this seed to raise an altar against every existing altar working against me. When you do that, you've gone behind her head. That is why the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 30, verse 19, I call heaven and earth to record this day. I call heaven and earth to record this day against that enemy, that I have set before you life and death, blessing and curses. Therefore, choose. Therefore, God is saying to somebody, what do you want? Do you want blessing? Do you want curse? Do you want to remain where you are? Choose. Life is filled with choices, but it depends on the choice you decide to make. You can make the wrong choice and remain where you are. You can make the right choice and go forward in life. But remember, there's a curse that needs to be dealt with. And if you don't deal, you don't have to be in the place for curses to touch you. As I told you, curses are faster than plague. They are faster than any fastest instrument. So if you are under a curse, don't worry about your surroundings. You don't know where it came from. It could be your generation, where you were born, and it's very far. I'm talking to somebody. Today is your day of restoration. You choose life. Somebody say, I choose life. Somebody say, I choose blessing. Come on, I choose life. I choose blessing. I choose blessing. I choose to be delivered. Say, I choose to be delivered from this curse. Say, Father, deliver me. Somebody pray that prayer. My Father, deliver me from this family curses. Open your mouth and pray. My Father, deliver me from family curses. Shake your body. You are sitting there. Why are you sitting there? Get up! And shake your body in the name of Jesus. My Father, deliver me from this curse that I'm operating on in the name of Jesus. Say, every power operating in my life, any power operating in my life negatively, break. Every power operating in my life negatively, break in the name of Jesus. Say, every curse operating in my life negatively, break, 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 break in the name of Jesus. Say, in the name of Jesus, every blessing that was swallowed by curses, every blessing that was swallowed by curses, I command you to change. I command you to come to me. Begin to bring back your blessings. Somebody bring back your blessings in the name of Jesus. What type of blessing? Promotion. Have you been demoted? Say, I break demotion. I receive my promotion. I receive my increase. Come on. I receive favor. Begin to receive favor. Begin to receive favor. Begin to receive promotion. Begin to receive prosperity. Good health. I receive good health. I receive expansion. I receive expansion. I receive expansion. I receive increase. Elevation. Elevation. Say, I am lifted. Say, I receive, in the name of Jesus, the blessings of the Lord. Today, I declare the blessings of the Lord over you, over your children, over your children's children. Every curse that has been tormenting you, every curse you've been operating on that kept you bound, in the name of Jesus, I break that curse today. I say, receive uncommon blessing. Receive uncommon success. Receive uncommon anointing. Receive expansion. Receive overflow. Your breakthrough, your fruitfulness, your prosperity, your increase, your abundance, divine health. Live in divine health. That sickness, that generational sickness in your family, I break it. The generational family sickness in your family, I break it. And I give you a bottled blessing today. Go home with these bottled blessings in the name of Jesus. Today, may you operate on these bottled blessings. That in the name of Jesus, no power can destroy you. No power can take the blessings from you. You are loaded. I say you are loaded. I repeat it. You are loaded in the name of Jesus. That curse, generational, ancestral, personal, family curses, whatever the curses you are operating on, today it is broken in the name of Jesus. Now, announcement. Number one, tomorrow I have faith clinic. Faith clinic from 10 to about 5, 6, 7. And come on time, because by 4 o'clock the door is shut. So yes, come on time. Yes, come and come with your problem, marital, physical, sickness, or whatever. God is there to heal you. Number two, Thursday is our miracle breakthrough service, where we go deep to deliver the sick, deliver all that are afflicted. So Thursday by 7 p.m., be in the house. On Friday, we start our marriage seminar. We start our marriage conference. So be in the house by 6 p.m. we are going to, you will not regret you were there. Come, husband and wife, there's going to be communion service. There's going to be deliverance. I'm going to pray for couples. I'm going to pray for families. I'm going to restore families again. Come with your troubled marriage. Come with your family. If your husband cannot come, your wife cannot come, bring a point of contact and lay it by your seat so that it's like he's there or she's there, but you are alone. But I pray that you can come with him if he's around. So on Saturday morning from breakfast, 8 o'clock, till there are some activities that God wants to use to bless you. Then talk about Sunday. Sunday is family Sunday. Sunday is family Sunday. Bring your family. Bring your children. And family anointing service. There will be family anointing service on Sunday for 8 a.m. and for 11 a.m. Your family will be blessed and your family will be anointed. We need to do that for families to be anointed in Jesus' name. So join the prayer line every morning. It's on the screen like that. Every morning by 5 a.m. we are in the prayer line. Every morning 5 a.m. on Wednesdays and Saturday, 5 a.m. and 9 p.m. 5 a.m. and 9 p.m. You don't want to miss it. Make sure you are there. And we are closing all chapter in this year, 2017, from the 28th to the 31st. From the 28th, every day, 7 p.m., come. Come, bring the old. We scatter the old and the new begin to take place. We begin to go higher. Then on that 31st, we are crossing over with victory. We are crossing over with success. So bring a friend, bring a family member, bring your people. Let them come and be. Let them come and share what God is doing for such a time as this. Somebody's receiving blessing. Somebody's receiving success. I've come today that whatever is operating over your life that wants you to labor under a curse in the name of Jesus, I separate you from that curse. If it is a human being, if it is a wicked power operating witch doctors, today I separate them from you, that the presence of the Lord, the anointing of the Lord, the power of the Lord, the victory of the Lord, wherever you go today, the presence of God go with you, the anointing go with you, his power go with you, as you prepare to go into your prophetic month of manifestation and power. So receive that fire now. In the name of Jesus.